we got then? What
here we have a TF, MGTF. Last of the T series, simple as that. And arguably, possibly the most popular. The old TF, never quite, they're an interim model between the pre-war style TC and TDs. And it was just run for about 2 years, probably. I think 53 to 55, prior to the MGA coming on the market. And during that period, it became really quite sought after. Lots and lots went abroad. Lots and lots went to America. In fact, most of them did. Most of the TDs definitely went to America, and I think most of the TS followed. But somehow, it must have been extremely popular in its day, although it only ran for that 2 years, because they are so highly regarded now by the age group that aspired to one all those years ago. So they must have been more popular than I give them credit for. I personally am not into them. I think a car of this shape needs individual headlamps. In other words, the proper shape, the proper model, really, style, finished with a TD, in my opinion. But obviously I'm wrong, because the TF is the most popular, so that answers it all, doesn't it? Lovely car, in black, lots of them factory black. Lots of black ones went to America. Lots of brown ones went to America. Odd colours over in America. They liked some weird pastel colours that we didn't at that time. We were traditional, weren't we? Red, green or white, really. That was about it. But nice red leather interior, as you can see. All been replaced. But older restoration. The hood and the side screens in it look very new. Very, very, looks brand new in actual fact. I doubt if that's more than a year or two old. And a lovely job made of it as well. Correct colour. All the framework is absolutely correct. That wants a strap put on there quickly, look, before that runs around and whacks onto that back wing there. And it's not got its covers on. There's the covers. They're in there to go on the sides of the petrol tank. Bit tatty, as you can see. You can buy them new now, so it's hardly worth really having them re-chrome. Plus the fact they're in a bit of a state. So someone might put them on, they might not. Nice dash. Nice square dials on the dash, or hexagonal, should I say, dials on the dash, which are lovely. Generally speaking, in really nice order. It's really lovely. So 1250, which is the most common. They went on to a 1500 engine, but they are quite rare. We've sold a few of them, but there are not many of them about. And then as we keep joking, it's got the run flat spare wheel, as you can see on there. Number plate looks about right. I can't really knock it, other than, unfortunately, it's got a lot of micro blister, which does need to be addressed sooner or later. What can you do with it? It might flat out. We had one absolutely identical many years ago that was very seriously micro blistered like that, and I managed to flat and polish them because there was a lot of paint on there. Now, I'm not gonna even attempt this because I don't know how much paint's on there, but this has clearly been flat and polished fairly recently, in recent years at least. So that tells me that that might well come out with flat and polish. But it does want some. Generally speaking, lovely old car, very saleable, very bright, nice chrome, nice straight panels. Haven't driven it myself. Cinturato tyre, there's a good thing, look. Look at that, period Cinturato tyres. They've been on there some years then. Back ones are newer, but the front ones are original. Nice condition wheels. Can't knock it really, can you? Other than, as I say, a bit of micro blistering to address.
It's not everywhere though, is it? It's a little bit tricky to pick up on camera, so it's not everywhere, is it? It's not covered in them.
I'll point to it. It's all across the bulkhead here, in and out the screen.
That's it.
And there's one or two little areas here and there.
Yeah, just a little bit on the rear arches, but you can't quite see it on video.
No, there's a bit there, look, but that will almost certainly come out.
Oh, definitely, yeah.
It's just
the bulkhead's the main bit, really, isn't it?
It just worries me a little bit on the bulkhead. Going to be a bit of an awkward job, going to be done by hand.
Yeah.
Simple as that, you know. But if it were mine, I bet I'd get them out. But I'm not going to risk it. It's not my responsibility. I'm not going to do it. All in all, lovely, desirable car.
Lovely car, yeah. I pulled it into the shed yesterday. Day before Saturday. And
sound nice?
Runs lovely, yeah. That's the point, man. Look at the rear, yeah?
Yeah.
Just press that button.
I'd have to invest in a set of overriders if it was me, but that's just me.
Run lovely, yeah. Sounded sweet.
And, nice and tidy and clean underneath there.
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
Nothing wrong with that.
Nice car.
Make a lovely motor for someone, that.
Ah.
Lovely thing. Very good.